गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ रुचिका शर्मा, योर ज्योग्राफी टीचर फ्रॉम कैम्ब्रिज इंटरनेशनल स्कूल दसुआ। आई होप यू ऑल हैव वॉच्ड ऑल माई वीडियोज टिल डेट, स्पेशली द प्रीवियस वन इन विच वी स्टार्टेड मैप वर्क ऑफ चैप्टर 3 ड्रेनेज। नाउ दिस वीडियो वुड बी पार्ट 2 ऑफ मैप वर्क ऑफ चैप्टर 3 ड्रेनेज। Before starting part 2, let's revise what we have learned in chapter 3 drainage map work part 1. Dear students, we had done Himalayan rivers in part 1 of map work. We already know that the Indian rivers are divided into two groups, the Himalayan rivers and the peninsular rivers. If we talk about the Himalayan rivers, then Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra river system are its subdivisions. First of all, let's revise the movement of Indus river system. The river Indus rises in Tibet near Lake Mansarovar. Flowing west, it enters India in the Ladakh district of Jammu and Kashmir. After crossing India, it enters into Pakistan near Mithankot. Beyond this, the Indus flows southwards, eventually reaching the Arabian Sea east of Karachi. The river has a total length of 2900 km. So, this was the movement of Indus River. Now, let's talk about second important river system of Himalayan rivers, that is the Ganga River system. The headquarters or headwaters of the Ganga, called the Bhagirathi, is fed by the Gangotri Glacier and joined by the Alaknanda at Devparag in Uttarakhand. At Haridwar, the Ganga emerges from the mountains onto the plains. The Ganga flows eastwards in West Bengal. This is the northernmost point of the Ganga Delta. The river here is divided into the Bhagirathi Hugli, flows westwards through the Deltic Plain to the Bay of Bengal. The main stream flows southwards into Bangladesh and is joined by the Brahmaputra. Further downstream, it is known as the Meghna and finally flows into the Bay of Bengal. The length of the Ganga is over 2500 km. Now, let's talk about the last river system of Himalayan rivers, that is the Brahmaputra river system. The Brahmaputra, like Indus River, rises in Tibet east of Mansarovar Lake and flows parallel to the Himalayas. On reaching the Namcha Barma, it takes a U-turn and enters India in Arunachal Pradesh. Then, like Ganga, Brahmaputra also enters in Bangladesh and joins Ganga River and forms Meghna River, which ultimately falls into Bay of Bengal. So this was the Himalayan river system that we had covered in part 1. Now let's start what we have to do in today's video. First of all, we are going to read about peninsular rivers and then Indian lakes. Students, now we are going to study second major group of Indian river system, that is the peninsular rivers. The peninsular rivers are divided further into two categories, the east flowing rivers and the west flowing rivers. The east flowing rivers of the peninsular India are the Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna and the Kaveri river. While the west flowing rivers of the peninsular India are the Narmada, the Tapi. Let's read each of these into detail. Firstly, the Narmada Basin rises in the Madhya Pradesh. It flows towards the west in a rift valley and on its way to the sea, the Narmada creates many picturesque locations the marble rocks near Jabalpur, where the Narmada flows through a deep gorge, and the Dhuandhar falls, where the Narmada river plunges over steep rocks, are some of the notable examples. Dear students, pay attention that the Narmada basin covers parts of Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat only. So this was all about the Narmada basin. Now let's talk about the Tapi basin. The Tapi river rises in the Satpura ranges in the district of Madhya Pradesh. That means Narmada and Tapi basin both originates in the district of Madhya Pradesh. The Tapi river flows in a rift valley just parallel to the Narmada, but it is shorter in length. Its basin covers parts of Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. The next important river basin among the peninsular rivers is the Godavari basin. The Godavari is the largest peninsular rivers and is also known as the Dakshin Ganga. It rises from the slopes of Western Ghats in the Nasik district of Maharashtra. Its length is about 1500 kilometers and it finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. Its drainage basin is also the largest among the peninsular rivers. The basin of Godavari River covers parts of Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, and Andhra Pradesh. The next river basin is the Mahanadi basin. The Mahanadi rises in the highlands of Chhattisgarh. It flows through Odisha to reach the Bay of Bengal. The total length of the river is about 860 km and its drainage basin is shared by Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Odisha. Moving towards the next basin of peninsular rivers is the Krishna basin. The Krishna basin rises from Mahabaleshwar and flows for about 1400 kilometers and finally reaches the Bay of Bengal. Its drainage basin covers the areas of Maharashtra, Karnataka, and Andhra Pradesh. Let's talk about the last river basin of peninsular rivers, that is the Kaveri basin. The Kaveri River rises in the Western Ghats and it reaches the Bay of Bengal in Tamil Nadu. The total length of the river is about 760 km. Its drainage basin is shared by Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. This was all about all the six river basins of peninsular India. You can have a moment to look at all of these. Dear students, we have discussed all about Indian rivers and now we are going to know the different important lakes of India, which are of various types. Lakes of India that we are going to study here can be freshwater lake, salt lake, and lagoon. Before moving further, I hope you all have understood the meaning of lagoon. Lagoon is a shallow body of water separated from a larger body of water by barriers, islands, or reefs. Therefore, lagoons are water bodies got separated from a larger body of water by barrier islands or reefs. In India, there are six important lakes. Let's enlist the lakes of India first. In freshwater lakes, we are going to study Wooler Lakes and Koleru Lake. And in the category of saltwater lake, we are going to study Chilika, Pulikat, and Sambar Lake. द फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट लेक ऑफ इंडिया इज वुलर लेक्स. इट इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फ्रेश वाटर लेक्स इन एशिया. इट इज साइटेड इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इन बंदीपोरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. द लेक वॉज फॉर्म्ड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ टेक्टोनिक एक्टिविटी एंड इज फेड बाय द रिवर झेलम. द साइज ऑफ दिस लेक वेरीज सीजनली from 12 to 100 square miles. The next important lake of India belongs to the category of saltwater lakes. The Sambar Salt Lake, which is India's largest inland salt lake, is located 80 km southwest of the city of Jaipur, Rajasthan. This is called salt water lake. That means salt can be produced from such types of lakes. The next important lake of India is Chilika Lake. Chilika Lake is actually a lagoon which has got separated from its larger water body. It is actually a brackish water lagoon spread over in the district of Odisha state on the east coast of India, covering an area of over 1100 km. Next we have Pulikat Lagoon. Pulikat Lagoon is the second largest brackish water lagoon in India after Chilika. The Pulikat Lake is located on the coastal line of Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh border. Now, let's know the location of Koleru Lake. Koleru Lake is located in the state of Andhra Pradesh and forms the largest shallow freshwater lake in Asia. Koleru is located between Krishna and Godavari deltas. Dear students, so in today's video, we have understood the locations of all the major river system of India and lakes of India. Firstly, we divided river system into two categories: Himalayan river, in which we have discussed the Indus river system, the Ganga river system and the Brahmaputra river system. Then we discussed in detail the movement of peninsular rivers, in which there are six river basins are given: the Narmada, the Tapi, the Godavari, the Mahanadi, the Krishna and the Kaveri river basins. After this, we discussed the location of the major important lakes of India, either freshwater lake or saltwater lake or a lagoon, in which we have seen five locations: first Wooler Lake, then Sambar Lake, then Chilika, Pulikat and the last is Koleru. Dear students, I hope this video helps you to understand the movement of river system of India and basically drainage system of India. So that's it for today. Keep revising, keep hard working and do well in your online quiz. Thank you so much.